DJs are the heartbeat of the hip-hop culture in a sense. They bring the beat, they actually fluctuate the rhythm, they keep us moving.
If I as a DJ can inspire people and help them practice a little bit harder, see that you can actually make something of yourself out of doing this, then I'll do it. I'm nothing special, I'm just an ordinary guy. Ordinary Joe, to quote Terry Callier in one of the best records ever written. I might be biased when I say DJs are probably the most important, but we are. By a long way. Definitely. If you put a record out, there's no better feeling than having a record on vinyl. How many people do it? One in a million, maybe, actually, gets a record now. But to put a record out, you can sell 1,000 and you can go back to working in Sainsbury's, but you have succeeded. You have taken part and you have joined in and you've changed somebody's view or opinion of what hip-hop is. The point of hip-hop is just to take part and enjoy. And hopefully it'll make your life a better one. Load of rubbish. Have fun.
Hey yo, money cash and green selling. It's all hot, make ourselves in the parking lot. Water crap, stop invasion. Fans be waiting for the answer. I'm taking chances, looking at the meat, I'm glancing. Not an ordinary glance, but the street glance. To make my vultures dance, it might be cold, but we on survival. My whole crew, we tribal. Rating all the pictures in your holy Bible. We on a level like disciples. Feeding the poor, burning items with the wisest.
Stuff that we're getting from overseas is a bit manufactured and conforming to a certain formula. And over here, we're just bringing the broad essence of what hip-hop was in the late 80s to the early 90s, before it became such a commodity like fast food, because that's how I really view it right now. You know, you order what you want, and you get exactly what you want without the onions and the pickles, but we're just bringing it to you with the mustard, the pickles, and everything else.
I started out in my house. My mum and dad were very strict, so I couldn't go outside. There was none of that. There was no playing, there was no bike riding, no knock, knock, treat, treat. It was all inside house reading books. So they bought me an album cassette deck. I started to listen to the radio, started to hear breakdancing. Then I watched John Craven's Newsround and saw breakdancing on that. Then the coffee table went to the side, started to breakdance, started to do my thing. What's up?
Yo, if the risk of my respect, gotta earn it. My epiderm is brown, gripping the pen, keeping a firm fist. Study my business hard like the furbest. Pen twist, veins getting fat as I'm getting a firm wrist. Cover a page hardly. My artery carry information like some sort of a scarly. Track like an infrared, source of info like the internet. Vocals hit the mic with human ears to intercept it.
Yo, who are you? Who are you? I'm sick of y'all following me.
The one thing with graffiti, which is obviously my first love, that I enjoy is that I don't have an art background, you know what I mean? I didn't go to art college, I haven't got a degree. I watched, I observed, I listened.
Graffiti spiritually takes me. At once, you're getting a whole story, you get the whole lyric, and you can analyze it. You know, you might see a head, you might see a spray can. All of these things make hip-hop.
I was kind of, I guess I was a wayward teenager or whatever, and I got kicked out of art classes and I wasn't allowed to do no formal art. I couldn't get into what they were asking me to do, and as a result, I wasn't allowed to like do it even as an O-level. We live in quite a repressive country, do you know what I mean?
Next, we are now going to talk to some of the girls that inspired all of us to get into it. The Cookie Crew. I'm so tired.
Hi, I'm Dee.
I'm Sue.
We're the Cookie Crew.
We're walking on the street, talking to each other. We said something that rhymed. We started laughing. We said, "God, you know, we should write it down." So we wrote it down, and then it turned into this rap, which lasted about an hour. We didn't have a clue about breaking, stopping, nothing like that. We went to America and made both of our albums. And if you made anything with anybody in America, you sold out. If you went on Top of the Pops, you sold out. Everything. So, it was all starting, and everybody was just trying to find how they felt about hip hop. When we went to the premiere of Beat Street, and the crowds outside were massive, and I don't know if people remember these things, but we used to wear these jackets called Gooses, and it had big fur around it, and that was really like all the breakers used to wear, and a name belt with your name on it, and Puma State, and our Ligi. When we went down there, it was just fantastic, pure just hip hop.
I can live with no money as long as I got my hip hop and this lamppost right here, right now. Yep, I can do it, I can live, all right?
I got a kill or be killed mentality. This ain't for charity, it's a favor for humanity. So on this one occasion, you can keep the salary. Don't ever try to understand my personality. In due time, you can feel the force raging. Hand me your mic, look how the world is changing. I remember times MCs were neglected. Now everybody wants to be a rhymer. Check it.
No place, no time.
Open the doors, let the savage in. Hard rhymes begin. Rappers in a state of distress.
I've been doing demos since 1983, 84. I got myself a tape-to-tape unit. And we used to, like, get instrumentals that were out at the time. And basically dub them over until we had our own instrumental. And then we used to just put vocals on it and claim it as our own. It's like, yeah, we're great. Just stole Roxanne Shanté's beat.
That was smart, you cut me off.
People tend to sort of have stereotypes about black culture, but I think hip-hop kind of breaks those down, because you can go to a party and you'll be hearing hip-hop and everyone will be moving to it, regardless of the colour, sex or race or creed. And I think, to me, that's what hip-hop represents. It's a positive change.
Hopefully, the outcome of this documentary is to make you understand that hip-hop is living. It's right around you. So when you see a flyer and it's saying hip-hop on it, don't imagine it to be a group of black gangsters.
I'm in London town. It's a foggy day. London town. It's a funky DL. It's representing Untu. You know, I stay in London. That's right. Stay cold. Stay cool. Stay mellow. The vibe.
In London town. In London town, a foggy day. In London town.
State of play.
Lately, no. Oh, isn't that him over there though? Stiff like a scarecrow. They think I'm a weirdo. The sore thumb surveys the whole field. The samurai, the spear, the gold shield.
This is Africa Bambaataa, and you watching the State of Play. And you better keep checking it out before I send my UFOs after you, sucker.
Forever hot stepping, forever on fire. The loose cannon, I let loose twice per annum. I have to ban them to let the enemy feel the venom. We brush the show. Let's say we do it my way. My way. All these DBs and their DB cliches. The Brixton factor is just to do this from the soul. Embodied in the body since 0 years old. We make a bounce.
Come on.
Bounce. We make the whole world bounce. Never calculate your worth to be a small amount. Every time we step on stage, we make the whole world bounce. We make a bounce. We make the whole world bounce. We make a bounce. We make the whole world bounce. Never calculate my worth to be a small amount.